I'm the founder of Chef Passport. We started around, as you know, more or less 1 year ago, while providing live streaming cooking classes to cooking enthusiasts from all over the world. So I'm very happy to have you here today. So the goal for today is that we would like to know more about you and your experience with Ramadan. You know, we're in a Ramadan period, and we have the privilege to have two chefs that are coming from countries where actually this festival is observed, and we would like to learn about you, learn more about you, the story, and how you are connected, and what are the dishes, the traditions behind this this festival. So I will keep it very short, handing over to Gaurav right now, and then we will have a series of questions for you.
Sure. Welcome thank again. You. Thank you, Matteo. So I'm the co-founder of the company. I love food and everything about food. So I've been working with Chef Passport since October of last year. So we were lucky to recruit both of you, Hira and Shery. I know, Hira, we posted an ad in Pakistan and you reached out to us. So we were super excited to get your application, and now we are here, all onboarded and ready to go. And I believe, Shery, we reached out to you, or you reached out to us on Instagram expressing your interest. So we are super happy to have you both onboarded on Chef Passport. So just to kick off, if you guys don't mind, just introducing yourself, who are you, where are you from, and what got you excited about Chef Passport. Maybe Hira, you can go first.
Okay. Hi to everyone. My name is Chef Hira Farooq, and I have done my professional degree and BS honors and textile, and then cooking is my passion, so I have decided to join the professional degree for getting a professional chef. So I have completed my graduation in a professional chef. Now I have been working since 4 years for the Pakistani food, and I love baking as well.
Cooking stuff, and it actually tasted pretty good for a first timer. So with time I learned that this is where what I want to do, this is where my passion is. I've been working for 10 years in like corporates. I was an employee, and at the same time I was like, okay, I'm more passionate about cooking and about exploring all the different cuisines of the world. I like traveling as well, so, and a big part of my traveling is exploring and eating and trying all the different specialties in the different countries. Putting all of this together, I started experimenting. Let's say 4 years ago, I started experimenting, making up kind of my own recipes, doing recipes with tweaks. And I'm specifically in love with the like everything that has to do with the Mediterranean region, and of course with my original Egyptian cuisine. So,
this video, maybe let's start with something very basic. So the Ramadan started yesterday, but what is actually the Ramadan, and what is actually, what does it represent for you? And maybe let's start with Hira.
This is not just having a fast, but we are practicing. We are practicing for a good deeds. Spiritually, we have to do charity, help the poor people, and offering prayers, recite our holy books. So this is actually the practices of being a good human being.
You're beautiful. And for you, Shery?
For me, adding to everything that Hira said, for me, it's, as she said, it's not only really about the food and the drinks. Many people, like including myself, actually, I choose one thing that I love so much, and that I think not everyone has the luxury to do it, to just stop doing. So it's just about feeling for others who cannot afford everything that you have, not only in terms of food or money or whatever. So it's just, I just mentioned a simple, stupid example. I'm a chocoholic. I love chocolate. I love sugar. All sweets.
Okay.
So you can think of it. Okay, you know what? That's something that I love so much. And not everyone can just have access to a big cheesecake whenever they want. So maybe I will just stop cheesecakes.
Okay.
The month. So
okay.
Just like that's also a way to see to look at it. But on the other side, from Egypt, like Ramadan is always a month of festivities. It's about gathering with the people you love, just sharing the things you love with others. It's about connecting, and even like calling people you haven't called for so long. People start calling each other and saying Ramadan Kareem, which is basically the if you translate it, basically Ramadan is a generous month. So we try to be generous, just like this month is teaching us kind of. So to me, it's, or in Egypt, it's more of a cultural thing. It's about the light, it's about the food, it's about the gatherings, it's about the connection with everyone around you.